Well, hi, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to the Dr. Joe Galati podcast, broadcasting high above the Texas Medical Center in Houston, purveyor of all things related to the liver, health and wellness, nutrition, food and cooking, and all-around doctor banter and witty repartee with our experts that visit us. Our website is drjoegalati.com. If you'd like to send me a note, subscribe to our newsletter, or even see me as a patient. If you want to call and be part of the program, dial us at 888-438-9431. And now, on with the podcast. Well, hi, everybody. Thanks for tuning into this episode of the Joe Galati podcast. And while I don't usually give any sort of formal introduction to the podcast, we usually replay the radio program, which is Your Health First, every Sunday evening when it airs. This particular podcast, I wanted to spend just an extra minute or two setting it up for what you're going to be listening to. And the podcast or the radio program, much to my surprise, is dedicated to V8, the fruit or vegetable drink V8 that essentially all of us are familiar with. And what started off as just a small segment of the program turned into essentially three quarters of this past week's program. And as I was going through it, I felt that it was worthy enough to spend the time and use as an example for how we ought to be thinking and the challenges that we face in that health and wellness journey that we're all on. Now, what I've included here as an added bonus or two commercials, two VA commercials. One is a little bit more recent. One is from 1977. The first one is 30 seconds, and I'll play that now and comment on it in just a second when it is done. Here it is.
Just gotta have a treat, oh, but you shouldn't eat. Wow, I could have had a V8. Snacking the whole night through, oh, what that does to you.
Wow, I could have had a V8.
V8 cocktail vegetable juice tastes great and is naturally low in calories, just 35 calories a 6-ounce serving. But remember, the time to think of having a V8 is before you've had something else.
Wow, I could have had a V8.
Now, what the commercial is, for those that obviously you're not seeing it, is basically three scenarios of people eating junk food. And the announcer comes in and says, hey, wait a second, you could have done something. And that familiar little slap on the head, slap on your noggin that alerts the person to say, hey, I could have had a V8 instead of a candy bar or a hamburger or something like that. So to their point, which I get into a little bit later in the podcast, it is a good alternative to a candy bar, a milkshake, or a Starbucks drink you're going to get mid-afternoon that has 1,000 calories in it. But I do think that even back in 1977, which absolutely seems like ages ago, they had the idea that snacking is not a good idea. And what is the alternative? Well, maybe V8 is the way to go. Now, the other commercial here, which is a little bit more recent, probably within the last 10 to 12 years, the setup is it's a mother sitting with a little baby in a carriage, and she is basically telling the little girl, I am having a French fry. And then you see this hand come out from the carriage and bump the mom on the head, sort of a throwback to the 70s-like commercial, alerting them to say, maybe you should have had a V8. So here is that pretty funny commercial right now.
Look what mommy's having. Mommy's having a French fry. Yes, she is. Yes, she is.
Could have had a V8. 100% vegetable juice with three of your daily vegetable servings in every little bottle.
Now, it should be stated that every little bottle is 12 ounces, which is more than a serving. So when I start getting into sodium content in V8, which it is very high, you're getting close to 1,000 milligrams of sodium per bottle. And so while the commercial is saying you could get all these servings of vegetable juice, the cost is a lot of dietary sodium. So anyway, so we will roll with the rest of the podcast here from Your Health First this past week. Don't forget, if you like the podcast, subscribe to it. Every week we've got a new episode, and certainly share it with your friends. And your feedback always, always, always is appreciated. Take care and enjoy the podcast now. Well, good Sunday evening to everybody. I'm Dr. Joe Galati. Thanks very much for tuning in on this Sunday evening to Your Health First. We're here every Sunday between 7 and 8 p.m., making all of you better consumers of healthcare. Our website, best way to get in touch with us, follow us along, is drjoegalati.com, drjoegalati.com. Now, on that website, you have essentially the launch pad for everything we are doing. Our medical practice, Liver Specialists of Texas, we take care of patients with liver disease, digestive disorders, cirrhosis, fatty liver, liver cancer, liver transplant at the Liver Specialists of Texas website, which is texasliver.com. You also have the launch pad for the radio program website, yourhealthfirst.com. You've got information about my book, Eating Yourself Sick, which is available on Amazon and other online services that you can certainly check out. And of course, all of our social media is linked to drjoegalati.com. Now, you could also take one of our patient surveys there on the drjoegalati.com website. Sign up for our newsletter. Send me an email. Any questions you have, it is all posted there. And of course, make sure you follow, listen, like, share our podcast. So our radio program, which you're listening to now, is later this coming week posted on the website. Sometimes it's shortened a little bit. Sometimes it's edited. Other weeks it is in its entirety. But the program is there in podcast form for you to re-listen to and share. We put an awful lot of work into making sure the information stays current and it's up to date for all of you. But do go to drjoegalati.com and check all of that out. So on the program tonight, it's one of those programs that I say it's more of a potpourri. It is dealer's choice. There are topics that I'm going to be chatting about that I believe are of interest to all of those that are listening and tuning in tonight. And let me, for those that are new to the program, I am certainly all about communication, not only with my own patients, but communication with all of you that are tuning in and following us, and making sure you have a good sense of direction. Now, week after week, I enjoy saying we're going to make you better consumers of healthcare. I basically want you to understand the landscape out there, because there is misinformation that is out there purposely to confuse you so that you possibly buy a product or buy a service strictly for the monetary benefit of somebody else. The other is that maybe the message is not being communicated squarely with you. And if you look at a particular advertisement, a particular program or article that you're looking at, you could, in a sense, misunderstand the essence of the message. And then by doing that, you sort of go off into left field and you are thinking with a false sense of security that everything is okay and that I truly understand what's going on. So what I do is, nearly every week, I try to bring to you things that are either brought to my attention or things that I see that I feel are important to everybody. Now, the first thing I want to try to get to tonight has to do with a product that you are all probably very familiar with, and that is V8, the V8 juice family of products that you see at your supermarket. You see them at gas station refrigerators, convenience stores. You see them inside a pharmacy refrigerator case. You see them at Costco and Sam's Club. V8. Now, the initial thought that most people will have pop into their mind is that V8 is good for you. And I have heard countless people tell me that because they don't like to cook or prepare or eat vegetables, they have V8. They'll have a serving or two of V8 and think that that is equivalent to eating vegetables. And that is certainly the impression that the manufacturer wants you to have, that if you don't have time, you're in a rush, and you really, really, really want to get those vegetables into you or into your kids or other family members, have a V8, that they are almost equivalent. Having a salad? I don't know about that. Having a can of V8 on the run? Now you're talking. That is really up my alley. But the truth is, you have to really stop, take a look at what is being advertised here, and see where the reality is, okay? So that's what we're going to try to do on the program today. So let us first just start with the nutritional facts, the nutritional value of V8. So this is the original V8 formula. It has about 50 calories. And let me get back. That is probably the biggest benefit of V8. It is low calorie. The problem I have with V8 is that it's very high in sodium. 640 milligrams of sodium per 8-ounce serving. Now, 8 ounces is about a juice glass. A typical more full-size glass in your kitchen, a tumbler, is at least going to be 12 to 16 ounces. So it's only 8 ounces, which is a juice glass. Carbohydrates are about 10 gram. The other problem I have with V8 is that it only has 2 grams of dietary fiber. So we're going to go back and look at the sodium, the calories, and the fiber. The other thing is, indeed, it is low in sugar. It's going to have 6 grams of sugar per serving. Now, the other confusing part is that there are so many different varieties of V8. There is the low sodium V8 juice. There's the spicy hot V8 juice. They do have low sodium spicy. They have a V8 essential antioxidant. Then they have V8 high fiber, V8 hint of lime, V8 hint of black pepper, V8 Bloody Mary mix. And then they have a V8 spicy mango vegetable juice cocktail and many others, which I'll get into. Not all of them, let me repeat, not all of them are made in the spirit of the original formula. But you will look at V8 and say, V8 equals vegetables equals good for me. I'm going to buy it. But you could make a mistake. All right, what we're going to do, we're going to take a quick break here. I'm Dr. Joe Galati. You're tuned into Your Health First every Sunday between the hour, the fastest hour in radio, between 7 and 8 p.m. Don't forget, go to drjoegalati.com Find out everything you want to know about us and the program and who we work with. And stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Everybody get up.
Welcome back, everybody. Dr. Joe Galati. So glad to be here with all of you tonight. Don't forget, go to drjoegalati.com. Sign up for our newsletter. I appreciate everybody taking a little bit of your time to spend it with us. Spin a little music. Try to domesticate you, but you're an animal. Baby, it's in your nature. And of course, raising the bar so that all of you listening tonight, either on the broadcast tonight, the podcast that you may be listening to later in the week or in the months to come, that you truly understand how and what you need to do to stay healthy and understand the challenges out there. So we are now continuing the dialogue on V8. And you're probably saying to yourself, when the heck was the last time I ever tuned into a podcast or a radio program or anything where there is somebody talking about V8 juice and making such a big deal of it? Well, I don't want, all I want to do is really enlighten you. And so when you go to the supermarket tonight, after the program, of course, or tomorrow or during the week, or you go visit your kid's apartment and you see cans and cans of V8, you could question them what they are thinking with regard to the nutritional benefit. All right. So now, in the last segment, I had said, I have a problem with the sodium. I have a problem with the lack of fiber. Now, let me just say this. There is nothing magic about V8 juice, the original V8 formulation. It is a ruse. It is a fake out if you think it is equivalent to eating a salad or vegetables cooked or raw, steamed, baked, however you want to cook it. And what you're getting in V8. The main thing is you are getting not that much fiber. Now, the reason I'm making a big deal about fiber is that we should all be taking around 30 to 40 grams of dietary fiber per day into our diet. A serving of V8 gives you 2.0, not a hell of a lot. Now, the other thing is the fiber in tomatoes, celery, the green leafy vegetables, carrots, these are all going to be very important in your health and wellness. Number one, eating the vegetables or the fruit in their native form is going to give you the fiber you need. Well, what does fiber do? Fiber is going to give you a sense of fullness. It's going to curb your appetite. The fiber in your diet is going to be very good in maintaining the healthy bacteria, the microbiome in your intestines. And more research, literally every week, scientific articles are coming out further understanding and explaining the benefit of the intestinal microbiome in everything from obesity to depression, to fatty liver, to fatigue, to Alzheimer's, just about everything. And the microbiome gets all screwed up when we are not eating dietary fiber, when we're eating highly processed foods that are low in fiber and the fiber is stripped out. So that is it. The other thing is you are getting, you know, we don't want to drink our vegetable. We don't want to sip our food. We want to eat it. We want to chew it. And if you think the easy way out, everybody wants the convenience. The easy way out of getting your vegetables is to just pop a can and drink it rather than having to chew it and put a little effort into it. it's going to create bad eating habits. Because again, if the advertisers get their way and they crawl inside your brain and they try to manipulate things and they try to lead you in the wrong way, you're going to be standing there at the supermarket or at home and making the conscious decision to say, do I eat my vegetables? Do I prepare them? Do I slice them and cut them? Or do I just pop a top and drink it? It's going to create bad eating habits. And bad eating habits are the root cause of obesity and diabetes and heart disease. So we have to think about that. Now, what I also did was I looked at other V8 products. And so this is typical for many different products out there. It's an advertising ploy. If you like V8 or you understand V8, the original formulation with the servings of vegetables, the two servings of vegetables, allegedly, it's two servings of vegetable fruit, not of an actual vegetable. So it's not, as they say, apples to apples. It is two servings of vegetable juice cannot be compared to two servings of vegetables, okay? Now, right alongside all of these original V8 products, they have V8 plus energy, V8 strawberry banana fruit blend. And so when you look carefully at these, they try to trick you to say that the strawberry banana V8 juice blend, it is 100% juice. Okay, plus one full serving of fruit and one full serving of a vegetable. But here again, look at the ingredients. Vegetable juice in the form of filtered water and concentrated juices of sweet potato, carrots, and beets. Fruit juice, filtered water, and concentrate juices of white grapes, apples, strawberries, and banana. Natural flavoring, banana puree, malic acid, citric acid, lycopene for color, vitamin C, and beta carotene. This is a fruit juice. This is not anything of any nutrition. Now, while on the label, it shows there's no fat, no cholesterol, there's only 80 milligrams of sodium, there's zero dietary fiber, there's 23 grams of sugar, okay? No added sugar, but still, from the fruit, there's 23 grams of sugar compared to the original V8, has only 6 grams of sugar. And so these other V8 fruit and vegetable blends like carrot mango, this is juice. This is just plain old unadulterated fruit juice of no significant nutritional value. So if you are thinking V8 equals vegetables, equals good for me, when you look at these associated products, garbage, no good for you. All right, we're going to take a break. My goodness, time is just flying here tonight. I'm Dr. Joe Galati. DrJoeGalati.com is the place to go. We will be right back. Yes, indeed, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. And in a sense, we are starting a revolution of sort in the health and wellness and nutrition space. And you're all part of it. You're tuned in. You're part of it. Don't you know that you can count me out? Don't you know it's gonna be all right? Yep, it'll be all right as long as we all have a good sense of what the heck we're talking about here with regard to your own health and wellness. DrJoeGalati.com is our website, DrJoeGalati.com. If you want to see me as a patient, we handle all aspects of liver disease, digestive disorders, obesity, fatty liver, cirrhosis. It's all there. Go to Dr. Joe Galati. And of course, our social media presence is all available there for you to go to Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and YouTube. I have a number of videos on YouTube. Instructional videos. That's what it is all about. All right. So, you know, this is live radio, and I show up here every Sunday with a set plan of attack. And I had only planned on talking about V8 juice or V8 cocktail. I don't know what, just V8, V8 juice, only for a few minutes. And here I am getting into our third segment. And in looking over it, I do believe that this is a worthwhile topic to elaborate on. All the other information I planned on talking about tonight, it'll be tabled, and we could talk about it next Sunday evening. But I do believe that this is a prime example of not only a product that we're all familiar with. We see it everywhere we go, at the supermarket, coupons, ads. You see it at Costco, mounds and mounds of V8. And then V8, the original formulation, comes in V8 different fruit juice combinations. And I know for myself, one of my kids, and it breaks my heart to think that they are under the false impression that a V8 product, pomegranate, berry, whatever, is good for you. You might as well just open up a bottle of grape juice and drink it down straight, because you're not getting any fiber, really no nutrition. And whatever the nutrition they're bragging about on the label, high in vitamin A, B complex, vitamin C, you could eat an orange, a simple orange, peel the skin and chuck it in the garbage. You will get as much nutrition and more by eating a piece of fruit, a handful of grapes, apple, various vegetables, a raw carrot. Eat that. You're going to get all the benefits. Now, as I said, going back to the beginning of the program, just as a reset, the original formulation of V8, to its credit, has 6 grams of sugar. All right, not too bad. And there's no added sugar to it. What I did was compare it to other popular drinks that are crowding the grocery store shelves. That you may say V8, or you may say, see, V8. Let me get this here. I've got so many papers on my desk here. It is the V8 strawberry banana, V8 carrot mango, V8 sparkling orange pineapple. This is not V8. This is V8 juice. No fiber and a little bit of B vitamins and vitamin C. Not a nutritious drink or substitution. Now, I'm going to give a plug as to why maybe you might want to drink V8 as a substitute. So if you could get your family, your kids, to drink V8 at dinner, V8 at lunch, V8 as a midday snack, over, let's just say, Snapple lemon tea. Everybody knows the Snapple brand. It has 72 grams of sugar, 36 within the lemon part, and 36 grams of added sugar. How about Snapple Grapeade? 86 grams of sugar. 86. It's a mouthful of sugar. Compared to the mere 6 grams in a standard V8. So if you take standard V8 as a drink, as a beverage, don't get duped into thinking, hey, Johnny, these are your vegetables today. Baloney. Sit down and have the kid eat carrots and tomatoes and peppers. Or cook them or learn how to cook them. But as a substitute for a beverage. Now, while we're on the beverage topic here, popular drinks that you may be tempted to buy and drink. A 600 milliliter bottle of Coca-Cola, 64 grams of sugar. Sprite, 52 grams. Solo. Now, I've never had Solo as a cola beverage, but it's pretty popular. 69 grams. Rockstar Super Sour Energy Drink, 67. Gatorade, 36. Lipton Iced Tea Peach Flavor, 26.4. Glacier Vitamin Water, Kiwi Strawberry Flavor, 22 grams of sugar. And so, how do we get our arms around this? Let me just recap my thoughts here. Number one, do not get confused and think that V8 is a substitute for eating your fruits and vegetables. It is not. It is high in sodium. And so if you are watching your salt intake, this is not a good choice. Now, they do make a low sodium version. That would be an alternative. Number two, it is essentially devoid of dietary fiber. So you're going to get all the fiber or a lot of the fiber you need, more of the fiber you need, by eating the fresh vegetables and fruit in their native state, be it cooked or raw. So it is not a good source of fiber. If you're not getting the fiber, then your intestinal microbiome, I talked about last segment, is going to get messed up and you're going to set yourself up for various chronic diseases. It is low in sugar. The key take-home point is you need to be able to look at these other flavored drinks and realize the amount of sugar they have, and it's going to lead to everything from dental decay, because you're not brushing your teeth, and weight gain, all right? And it's not going to make you feel very good. The other thing is, as a substitute for these other beverages, I will give the green light to have V8, but only for that reason. Only for that reason. Now, other ways you could sort of use V8. Now, everybody is making smoothies, and I think smoothies, for the most part, are okay, but you can get tricked. This is a whole other topic. You could get tricked into putting a lot of bad stuff into your smoothie, and so you start off with fruits and vegetables and fiber, but then you adulterate the thing by all sorts of other commercially available products that are not that good for you. So I think if you want to add a little bit of V8 into your smoothie, that would be a good idea. If you want to use it, something that you're cooking with, a lot of people will throw V8 into different soups. They'll throw it into various types of sauces. Again, it's going to be high in sodium, but you could make use of it there. But the main take home, which I hope all of you have heard with the time that we've invested in this, is that V8 is not a substitute for eating your fruits and vegetables. And you have to be very, very leery as to some of the other V8 products making you think that you are getting the same fruit or vegetable juice as the original formulation. The other drinks that V8 is putting out there is nothing more than juice. They want you to believe it's more nutritious, but it's no different than just opening your gullet and drinking down 8 or 12, 16 ounces of straight apple juice.
Thanks for listening today to our podcast. Don't forget, for more information, check out drjoegalati.com. Information about my book, Eating Yourself Sick, is available there, as well as our clinical practice, radio program, and social media links. We need you to be part of our tribe and community. Until we meet again, I'm Dr. Joe Galati. Ciao.